What's up everyone, I'm Ola England. Welcome to another FAQ video part 7563. But before we're gonna check out your questions, let me show you my new 14 amp and let's check if it will chug.
God damn it, that was probably the worst intro for YouTube ever. I'm not Ola England, I'm not from Sweden, I'm not blonde enough, and honestly, that's not even a solo guitar, but shh, don't tell anyone, it's just a solo. Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. This time it's an FAQ video. Before we start, let me say thank you to all of you who sent me so many questions, actually too many questions for one video. And yeah, I tried to answer the majority of them, and some of you had very similar topics, so I'm gonna put them together in one big question. I hope you enjoy this video. Enough of the blah, blah, blah. Let's start with your questions. I'm Krim, by the way, and I like to play drums, in case you didn't know. First question, James is asking, what are three things you need to have take when going on tour? First, I would say earplugs, because you can imagine it's a very loud and noisy environment. So you wear them all the time, off stage, backstage, on stage, underneath the stage, doesn't matter where. And even at the bus, I wear them because engine noises or bandmates are still having a party. And when I want to sleep, I just pop them in and I'm good to go. Second thing, I would say my good old iPod Classic. I have a lot of music and audiobooks on there, and we are traveling a lot of miles, so it comes in very handy to have some entertainment. Plus, it's the backup of the backup of the backup, so in case something is wrong with our sampler, I still have the old school mono mix down of our show. And a third thing, you can imagine fresh underwear and socks, because this is really a necessary thing, always. Achilles is asking, how do you deal with a bad day on a tour show? Like if you feel your body really tired or unable to perform as good as you want. Cheers from Greece. Whoppa. Thank you, Achilles, for your question. Greetings back to Greece. Happens to everyone. When you play like 1 month and let's say 3 weeks of this 1 month is without a break, you can imagine that on some days you will be really tired or maybe you're sick. And I feel this usually when I wake up and then I know, okay, good, it's time to eat a lot and sleep a lot, maybe take a nap before the show. And then I try not to push as hard as I would usually do on such shows, because I know that it's not my best day. I just try to survive, but yeah, just go with the flow, enjoy the show. Go with the flow, enjoy the show. And I still try to give 100%, even this 100% is not on the same level, let's say, some days ago. But yeah, that's all that counts, and there will be better days. Let's talk about bass drum pedals. A few questions about that. One is, are twin pedals limiting the drummer? Are we really need to get separate bass drums symmetrically? It's not that they're limiting the drummer, it's just a different feeling. With some bass drum pedals, especially in the lower price range, you definitely feel a big difference between the slave pedal, the one that is connected with the drive shaft, and your main pedal. So this is annoying to me, and this is annoying to many drummers. If you go up with the price, there are pedals that don't have such an issue. But there are many drummers that actually prefer a double bass pedal. Why do I play two singles? Yeah, first of all, it's more comfortable for me. And second of all, it's nicer to record because you have the right and the left, It's nicer because you get the right and the left bass drum separated. So you can throw on different EQ, different compression. I mean, talking about studio environment. But two bass drums, it's more expensive. You need more space, you need another case, you need another drum head. So you should think about that. I go with two singles. Maybe you like to play with a double bass pedal instead. Some people ask me what double bass pedals do I recommend cheaper than my pedal, the Charge Copito. I'll show you my pedal first. This is the one, this is the monstrosity from Poland. It's a custom direct drive pedal from Poland called Charge Copito, which means devil's hoof. I just call it Polish tank because it is as heavy and solid as a tank. But I understand if this might be too expensive for you at the beginning and you want something a bit cheaper but still solid, then I would go for an Iron Cobra pedal, just a classic Iron Cobra double bass pedal. And I think it's a good value for the money. And in case you want something more fancy, something that is super, super high-end, will last longer than you for sure, and a direct drive, then I would definitely recommend you going for the Charger Capito pedal. Amazing. Can you grow your beard, please? I'm so curious, gonna look awesome. Which beard, bro? There is no beard, you know? I'm 30 years old and... wait a second. I'm not 30 years old anymore, I'm 31 years old. Time is running too fast, god damn it. Yeah, so, but I will always look like 12, so forget about it. I will not grow my beard, nope. Let's talk about blast beats. A few questions about blast beat. Hi Krim, wanted to ask you, what is your approach to blast beat? Hand position, grip, do you play wrist or mainly only fingers for blast beat? Also, what stick size do you use and why? So I use Promark 419 drumsticks, which are pretty heavy drumsticks. I would compare them to 2B drumstick. And I like to have thicker drumsticks because there is more rebound and the weight of the stick just gives me more sound overall. What is my approach to blast beats? I like to play blast beats, that's my approach. But I don't play blast beats for such a long time. So in songs, I would not use it as the main beat. I would more use it as the climax in a song. So I try to play blast beats very powerful, maybe shorter than some other guys, but yeah, it has to be really in your face. And I use mainly the wrist, or actually exclusively the wrist, because there is the most power to get out of. Only if I have to play really, really, really fast stuff, then I try to also push with the fingers a little bit. And a good exercise, because someone asked about this too. Yeah, here, how you build a good progress for blast beat technique. Any special exercise you have to do to make good progress for blast beat technique? Blast beats are very demanding for your hands, so you have to work more on your hands than on your feet. To develop your wrist, I would recommend playing on a pillow because there's almost no rebound, and then you have to do all the work with your wrist. In case you wanna work more on your fingers, let's say the flying finger technique, then you need something with rebound, and I would guess a normal rubber pad would work, and you do the same exercise. But I'm all about wrists. What do you think about the drummer of Megadeth? Derek is an amazing drummer. He's an amazing human. He can play whatever he wants. You know, he can play complex stuff, groovy stuff, very unique stuff, fast stuff. And this guy has been in the business for so long. And yeah, like I said, amazing drummer, big respect, big inspiration, Derek. Much love to you, you're amazing. Nathan asks about guitar theory stuff. Hi Krim, I would like to know if you have any guitar theoretical knowledge, like knowing note scales, that you use compose guitar for your solo project, or do you do everything by ear and feeling? Do you compose songs that you never published because you didn't like it before starting your solo project? Hope to see you again on the road. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff I have not released because it's basically shit. That's why it's not released. And I have no knowledge whatsoever. I just pick up the guitar, I use it as a tool, and I just try to place my fingers on the fretboard and try to find notes that work properly and sound pleasing for my ears. Because it works for me. Just take the guitar and jam around and write songs. It works very well. I can only recommend. Amanda was asking, how does one correctly pronounce Adidas? Is it Adidas or is it Adidas? Someone is asking, I want to know what exercise you do or did to improve your foot technique. What I'm doing to exercise for my foot technique is called the bass drum pyramid, which I will show you right now. So what I did here is I just set a tempo and then I play through different note values, and It's a great exercise because you learn how to play triplets as well, and you learn how to change your bass drum technique from full leg to ankle motion or to swivel technique or whatever you're using. And believe me, it's very difficult, and you will definitely find uncomfortable tempos in there for sure. What trigger you use and why? Let's talk about triggers. I have a trigger called the foot blaster, and the foot blaster is a small trigger that sits on the bass drum. It's this guy right here, this one you see. And the cool thing is with the foot blaster that you can even play against the couch and it will still work. And you know why? Because when you push down the pedal, at the same time you will hit the bass drum head, it also touches the trigger down here, yeah, and then it fires. So it's a really cool device. And some people ask me about how reliable are those things, because I saw pictures of people breaking them, and I don't know how you guys are doing this and never had any issues. This specific set of triggers, this one right here, I have on there for almost 2 years, I would say. I've played a couple of tours with them, many practice hours. I was bending the metal up and down. It still works perfect, so I can only recommend you. The foot blaster, this is the thing, this guy. Probably one of the most important questions ever to increase your double bass speed is, what is the best kind of person to sacrifice for unholy double bass technique? Virgins? Arrogant guitar players? How about vocalists that don't help carrying stuff? How do you tune your kick drum? High, medium, or low? I made 3 videos for my YouTube channel, and I show how I tune my whole drum kit, and one is just for bass drum, so check this one out, but I give you a little tip. What are your thoughts of your first ever tour? And when you were about to go on your first ever tour back in the day with Decapitated, did you have any expectations of what touring would be like? And was the touring anything like that you imagined, expected it to be? Greetings from Finland and stay safe. Yeah, I was a small kid. I was just 20 years old, and my first tour was back in 2010. And it was in the UK. It was just 1 week long, and it was Cataclysm, Decapitated, and Man Must Die. I was really excited. I remember going in the Nightliner, first time being in a Nightliner, first time getting a tour pass. I was taking a picture immediately of the tour pass, not with the phone, but you know, with the small compact camera. And it was really a big deal for me. Also, it was the first time that I had to play every day, you know, for a week. I could experience how it is carrying heavy equipment downstairs, and also after the show when you're super sweaty and tired, 2 a.m. you have to carry it back up to the trailer. I remember some venues, it was like Irish pubs with barely any stage, no backstage. It was dripping down from the ceiling because it was so hot and moist in there, and people were falling on the stage, and it was wild. I did not expect that, but it was cool. It was really cool, and nothing has changed ever since. It was a cool time, great memories. Okay guys, that's enough for this video. We're gonna continue with more questions next week. I hope you enjoyed this part. Leave a comment, subscribe, notification bell, all this crap. You know, you're adults. I don't have to tell you what to do, right? If you want more videos, you know what you gotta do. It's 2020. YouTube has been out for quite a while. Anyways, it was a pleasure. Be safe and see you soon.